Are you someone that struggles with the metal grinding in Battlefront Classic Collection? Well, if you are, I am here to help you today. So, on my Darkmoor516 account, I have everything to Legendary, all these medals. The hardest two most people struggle with was Demolition and Technician. So I'm going to walk you through some of those. Now keep in mind, I'm going to show you this pretty quick, but see how it says 4 kills with the Gunslinger, 1 life? That's because I got it to Legendary, it's normally 6. Which I'll show you on the other account I just made. See, it says 6. So it changes as you get it to Legendary. You require less. Like, for another example, the War Hero goes from 36 to 27 points in 1 life instead. So keep that in mind. Another thing as well I'm going to touch on is basically how the medals work and the trophies. So if you achieve a medal feat for the first time, you'll get a trophy. So if you do the 6 kills in 1 life for the first time, you'll get a Gunslinger trophy. And then when you get it to each of these ranks, so there's 3 other ones. So you get it to Veteran, which is 4 medals. You get a trophy for that, for each one. So you get each one to Veteran, get that to Veteran, you get a trophy for both. And then with 32 is the Elite, and then Legendary is 64. So you'll get a trophy each time you get a medal to that rank, and yeah, that's pretty much how it works. It's just a grind, especially for Technician and Demolition, which is these two I've just marked. So I'm going to show you some of my favorite maps and a few cheeky tricks to get that done. The first one I'm going to show is Demolition, and the reason I'm putting the AI to 0, which I didn't know you could get it to exactly 0, is to help you with the Demolition. Now, David told me this strat. So basically, how this works is you have to be the Rebellion. The weak point in the critical hit is the AT-AT neck. But the best part is, these walkers will still spawn in no matter what. And no one controls them, so they don't move. Making the critical hits even easier. So, yeah, you don't have to up the reinforcement count, because you need it 64 times. So if you want to do it all in one match, you can. But I did it a couple times, matches at a time on a different day. But basically, you just fly over there and get the 4 hits. Yeah, if you want to really be cheesy and do it in one go, don't capture the command posts, because their reinforcements will go down. This one's solely for the Demolition. So you basically just shoot this neck with the launcher 4 times and you will get the medal. Now the first time you do this you will get a trophy, but I won't because I've already done so. But basically you just get your 4 critical hits. Now you're going to have to respawn each time though, because you're going to do it in one life. I don't know if it works with the actual award you get. I know it does when it's Legendary, but let's say I did it now, I got the award, and I respawn it too quickly, and if it's still there, it might not work. So just keep that in mind, that was always a thing in the OG Battlefront version. So usually what I did is I waited a couple of minutes, then respawned, and then I went from there. But don't do what I just did and back out, because it won't work otherwise. So keep that in mind, because you need to finish the match first, then quit, because it will save your progress. So another one of my favorites, just to grind for almost every single one except for Demolition and Technician, is Capture the Flag. Now you can up it the AI bots more, but just to make sure I can do the video for you guys and actually just showcase the medal, I'm going to do it on the normal amount of bots. So 10-4, Capture the Flag. Now part of the reason is because there's no ticket limit, so if the teams don't get to that amount of flags, the match will keep going. So this is my favorite one. You can basically get Frenzy, which is 12 kills with a rifle, which is what I've got here. 6 kills with the pistol, you get your Gunslinger. And you can also get all the other ones in one life as well, which I'll touch on in a moment. Now for this map in particular, this is the main corridor where they go into. So keep that in mind as well, it's quite a cluster. But also the lock-on system, as you can see, comes up. That is so helpful to have. And just like that, I've already got endurance, like how quick that went. And I've already got 7 kills out of 12 already. So if you quick out the bat and use that lock system and aim assist, it helps a lot. Like, you don't have to have the best aim in the world, just adjust your sensitivity if you have to, keep it steady, and off you go. Now, near the command post is where a lot of them are, so you don't have to go in straight away. There's my Frenzy already. Already got 12 kills. See how quick that was? And I've already got the Guardian as well. Like, see how quick that went? I've already got 2 kills out of 6 with the Gunslinger. Now, for those who struggle with the pistol, What I suggest is weaken them with the rifle, like that. Get a few shots. I did it the wrong way around there, but... Oop, and I just killed him too quick. But when you aim for the head, that's what I recommend also doing. And it'll kill him so much quicker. And watch that engineer, they can sometimes one-shot you, so be very careful. I fell into that trap a lot, and I'm almost at War Hero as well. So I think I need one more kill to get the Gunslinger, so someone's going to pop around the corner here. Yep, there's your Gunslinger. And I'm 1 point away from War Hero as well, so let's quickly pick off this guy. Bang. So look at that, so I've got Endurance, Guardian, War Hero already the points, and I've got Frenzy and Gunslinger. So that's 5 medals already, just in one life alone here. Imagine how many times you can do this when you actually, you know, have the Capture the Flag mode and just up it to like 10 or 15 is the max. Now, I mentioned before getting other medals in one life, so I can still go for Regulator and Marksman if I want now. So you just, for us on PS4, you press Triangle and you can just change your class. So you can do this without respawning, which is great. So if I want to get the Marksman now, 6 headshots with the Sniper, I can do so. Now, near where that corridor where we're just in before is where I like to usually be because there's less people. If you try and do it in this corridor, it's very difficult. When it's quieter like this, you might be able to get them. But my go-to is this one, this corridor here. Less people come in, and when the AI do, when you're on this side of the map, they will come from up there. And often you'll find a pattern in their AI where they sometimes stop for a second to track you and actually go, wait, where's that shot coming from? I didn't mean to throw that grenade. But often they do that, they'll stop, and that's when you want to hit them. Even though I one-shot that person there, but basically, yeah, when the AI is up to 32, more bots will come through. So see how he stopped to track where I was there? That's when you want to get them. So even if you missed the first shot, doesn't matter. Just aim for the head and you'll get them again. Oh, I missed, but see how they keep stopping. It's an AI pattern. You can make use of that. Especially when you're not the best marksman here, because trying to kill them while they're moving does take some practice. So basically you can farm that as well. Oh, see how they stopped again? It's a pattern, so you can make use of that. And I'll show you another couple good maps for marksmen as well, that I recommend for you. Oh, behind me. I've got to back out of there for a minute. But yeah, that's what I make use of. If I've cleared through them and I don't want to stay there, sometimes I'll spawn here, so I can always wait up the corridor, but the danger is that door there, and they flank you. So there's a danger in that. Otherwise, you can just sneak up here, put an auto turret behind you, and then pick a few people off here. Look, they stop again. Oh, that got in the way. See how they stop? Stop again. So get them, if you're bad at aiming, get them when they don't move. So they will stop. Oh, I missed a shot there, but see what I mean? It makes it so much easier to get that marksman medal. I think they're trying to shoot my turret. Oh no, they weren't. But even though I'm a bit sloppy with the aim at the moment, normally I'm a lot better, but see how easy it can be to actually just get those trophies? Like, it works so well. And there's your marksman right there. And now I can go back, get the regulator if I want, so I can switch to the engineer. Now, I am going to... I'm getting flanked here, so I'm going to be very careful. Look, but you don't have to do it this way. This is probably the most efficient one. If you want to, if you're better at a certain one, just focus on that one first. Sometimes people prefer to grind that way. But that's also what I should suggest. There's a really good trick for the technician, which I'll show... Actually, I'll show that now, actually. But yeah, you can switch to the engineer after that if you want, get the regulator, and then keep going. But my favorite map for the regulator and technician, they'll go hand in hand, is Polis Mussa. And Giltron actually originally told me this one. But for this to work, for this particular map, you have to be the droids. Reason being, when you go outside of the map and outside onto the asteroids, normally you take damage, but because you're a droid, you can't. So, spawn at number 6 where I usually go, pick the engineer. Now, the technician requires the fusion cutter, which the engineer class has. So, yes, the droids making a sound here, but you're not actually taking damage. right? Because you're a droid. So you basically just run out of here. The clones will usually always pick an AAT from that command post, so I just run to that one. And I pretty much get close to this vehicle and you start slicing. So you hold down the attack button with the fusion cutter. And you just get it to 100%. So try and stay really close to them for this to work. See how I went to see they got far from me? So keep up for the number to keep going up. And there's your technician. And I died, which is fine. But basically, when I do that, I eventually get over to... The technician should work if you slice again. But let's say I did that. I'll go over to number one, because usually by then... Like, I'm usually able to kill the clones that come out of that vehicle quick enough. Oop, I'm dead again. They're not letting me go past there. Normally it's a smooth run for me, but basically you go over there, which I'm going to make sure I do. You know what? I'm just going to cheese it this time. I'm going to go in a vehicle, because normally I don't die like that. Normally I just, you know, run straight through there. But let's say I make it. I pretty much spawn trap the enemy at this command post. Oh God, they're actually hitting their shots today. All right. There we go. So this is one of their furthest command posts. So basically what I'll do, I'll hover in and out of the asteroid if there's too many of them and try and hit them. Oh, that was a good hit. Careful of those engineers though, they can one-shot you. But if you're not good at shot, get them close to you, aim for the head, and it one-taps them. See? I'll reload. And you get 8 kills with the shotgun to get your regulator. Because they unless they're chasing a vehicle, they won't come out. Look, and like that, there's your regulator trophy right there. Now, for the purpose of the video, I am going to back out, but that is how easy that is. You can do that over and over, up the ticket count, and just go nuts. Now, for the marksman, for actual long-range maps, I'm going to show you one. Now, for the purpose of this, I'm going to do Kashyyyk Capture the Flag, because you can also... This is a good map for slicing as well, I find. Do I still have it up to 10? Yes, I do. Now for this one, I will do to 32 just to make it easier to spot some people. But I'm going to show you a couple different maps that are good for sniping. Now for this particular map as well, no matter which side you pick, for the clones we'll have a bark speeder and the droids will have a stab. If you want to do your slicing for the technician medal, they slice much quicker. And they'll always spawn from this end, that end, so you can always go for your medals from there. Now that is a really good map, and it's going to take a while for them to actually shoot back at you. So, if you've got a really good aim, do this quickly. Now, I am taking some damage there, but that's okay. But that's a good spot. If you're doing normal conquest, the best spots are probably up there, because there's one of your command posts up there. Or you can go behind this barricade. Usually the droids blow it up anyway. But you can go up here. Okay, I'm going to be dead in a second, so I hope they don't spot me. Now you can go up here. Some of your AI marksmen actually go up here. So with that in the way, you can always just crouch here. And you've got a good view of the map from here. So you can double zoom in. And you can get your headshots. And it's got good range, so most of the map you'll be able to cover. Now you've got to remember, to get the metal marksman, you need a headshot. So keep that in mind as well. But because it's Capture the Flag, they're always going to be coming this way. Which makes it even easier. Recon droid, I don't want you. I'm so used to pressing square for that button. But you should be able to get it from here too. Oh, I missed. But again, look for their patterns. There you go. See, look, I've got marksman. Even I'm nearly dead. But yeah, you can sit back here. And then... You can't see it, but look at the stab. They always guard that. That's too far away for me to snipe, but... Actually, I'm going to quickly respawn and show you. But they slice the quickest. That kind of thing. So what I'm going to do is get the engineer. Is there a box bit over here I can borrow? Yeah, there is. So this is what I was starting to do as well for technician if I didn't want to do Pulse Master. Just a change of variety is good. So I will pretty much speed up there. You know, again, you can if you want your point medals, you can do it at the same time. You know, just, you know, capture your objective. And see how the stats here. Watch how quickly you... Oh. Okay, they're all my fun. I suggest going around. But... I'm going to make sure I quickly demo this. Normally I do it so easily. Is there a... Okay, sorry, mate. I'm making a video, so I'm gonna borrow your TX-130. So, actually, I'm gonna kill those on the way. Normally, if you're a Barkspeed, you'll just zoom in. Hopefully, that Barkspeed is still there. Oh, and of course, they're gone. Are you serious? Oh, there's one step. Can they come back? But they really like making it hard for me, don't they? But normally they're right there as they were before, they're just sitting there. This is also a cheeky spot if you want to get your regulator as well, you can kind of... There'll be less people back here. But basically what I'm trying to tell you is you'll go to, you'll take like, go from 50 to 100% and then that third slice is where you get the metal. Wait, I can hear a stab. Anyone else heard that? Oh, there it is. Alright, if I can sneak on him. I want to quickly show you how quick this is. Look how easy this is. Now, don't spot me. Don't spot me. Watch. See? So that's easier than what I did on Polis Master. So if you want to do it on here, or even on any of the maps, you can do it there. Watch those wrist rockets. That's a nostalgia meme for you. But look how easy that was. You know, you can do that. You can even do that on Geonosis if you want. They'll have the stats there too. But see what I mean? Like, so many of these medals, except the Technician, I mean, actually, on some maps you can. Everyone except Demolition is probably, you can almost get them in almost all the maps, like, a lot of the maps have vehicles. Now, also, one more thing, one more map I want to show you, a good map for sniping is Camino. And I want to touch on one more point about that slicing. So, either go the Rebellion or the Droids from one of my favourite spots, but honestly, on this map, there's no right or wrong. But for Torrents, you can't slice them. But you can snipe off them, people off them. And that's a good way to get your headshots, which I'm going to show you what to do here. So I like to spawn at Command Post 5 and get on this balcony up here. And even though I didn't increase the boss up to 32, but they will still run the same way. They come from this bit here, so their Command Post is down there. They will run up here, and you better get them. But they'll go in this a lot. Watch. If they keep doing it, he's trying to get in. Whoop! See, that's already two kills right there. How easy is that? So you can snipe them off the turret and get the headshot. That's a cheeky one. You can always go on, if they go on the turret out there, and this guy's going about to go on it. Like, that's already three right there. Like, how easy is that? You don't even have to be a proficient shot on this. He was about to go on it then, but see how the AI are programmed? Use the AI and how they are to your advantage. So I've already got a few headshots out of the bat right there. Now, if they go on other turrets, that you can shoot them. There's one normally there, or there, you can reach these. And you can reach that one back there. I think this one back there you can too, but no one's on it at the moment. But how easy it is. Look, and again, the AI programming, if they stop, use that to your advantage if you're not a good shot. Look for the ones that are still. You don't have to be the best shooter in the world to actually get your marks and medals. As you can see, my aim's not the 100% the best right now, but look, how easy is that? You get your marks right there. Now, if you're too afraid to die, you can always get your War Hero medal and that from back here. But look, you can snipe them off that. That's the easiest way to get your headshots on a map like this. There's another turret back there, which is my teammate, but I can headshot him if I wanted to right now. So that's my favorite map. This is my favorite spot simply because you're back here, you're covered. Unless they actually capture your command post, they're not going to push you straight away. And you can just shoot. You've got really good range on this map. This is good cover as well. It's my favorite spot. But depending on your faction, there's no right or wrong. You can always be at the other end and do the same thing. Look, there's another Wookiee up there. You should be able to get him from there too, but that's one I like to do. Now, you can't slice these turrets to get your technician. It has to be a vehicle. And again, as I mentioned before, the stab's probably the best option. And that's pretty much the gist of it. Another one of my favorite maps to do is Mustafar Capture the Flag's another good one, because that's a pretty close quarters chaotic map. If you're not the best shot, that's probably your best option. Oh, there's a clone. Boom. Oh, a stormtrooper. Bang. But, yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. And you can just keep going. The best advice I can give you, regardless of what I've said today, is one of two things. One, farm this at your own pace, you know? I mean, some of them I found really easy because I was pretty good at them as a kid. And then, wait, what's he doing on that? Get him off. And two, you can do it on any map you want. You can also do it on Conquest, I mean Galactic Conquest, I mean. You can do it on instant action, and you can even do it in the campaign. But I prefer instant action, because, you know, it's not really going to matter, because Galactic Conquest, a lot of us, you know, really just want to actually win. And sometimes you'll play more aggressively than you want. But yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. So just to recap again, make use of this to change your classes mid, like during your life, if you want to get the other medals at once. Farm at your own pace if you choose to do so. Just enjoy the game. I mean, yes, there's a bit of a grind, and I would have liked the trophies to have like a Galactic Conquest trophy or something like that, or even a Hero Assault one, but at the end of the day, this is what you got, and the medals, you know, they're a good achievement. Like, you're basically just playing a lot of all the classes for a good while, you know. But I hope you guys enjoyed and actually got something from this. Pretty much a lot of the good maps for Marksman as well are like open maps and where you get good cover. You don't have to be in the fight to get your Marksman medals. Same with your like Frenzy and stuff. You could always be from here and just zoom in and get them. Again, look for the ones that stay still and get a headshot with them. Like, you know, if I was getting the Marksman again, that's already 3 kills out of 6 that you got to get. And there's another guy right there. Even though I missed that one, but that would have been 4. But look how they stop a lot. Again, make use of that. Make use of the AI patterns. And just enjoy the game, really. That's pretty much the best advice I can give you. And just take one at a time. I definitely suggest leaving the Technician one and Demolition till last, just to make it easier for you. Especially if you're someone like me who prefers to do it in the fight. When there's people around, they might shoot you before you get that chance. But regardless, I want you guys to enjoy it. Just have a bit of fun. My birds are going a bit off now, so I'm going to wrap it up there. But let me know your thoughts, let me know how you're going on the trophy grind, and if you need some extra help or tips on certain maps, on like what area of the map to go to, let me know and I can actually discuss it with you in the comments. But again, have a good day, let me know if this video helped, and I'll catch you all next time.